I'm Professor Bill Watson. I'm a professor in learning design technology at Purdue University in the College of Education. So I really think personalized learning is where AI can have a profound effect on our educational systems. You know, in the current system, it's very teacher-centric. The teacher is the one providing all the activity. They're the ones designing the instruction, lecturing often, giving students feedback, grading their assignments. It's putting a very, very heavy load on the teachers. And as such, because such a heavy load is on the teachers, the students are often in a very passive mode where they're sitting there, they're expected to absorb. There are one of many, so they're expected to be quiet until they're called on, and it's teaching them to be passive learners. Today's society, we need active learners, we need problem solvers, we need people who are creative, and that means we need a personalized learning experience for the students, and that's what AI can give us. It's impossible for a teacher to manage where 25 different students are in any given time if we're not operating on a class sort of schedule where the calendar is driving everything. So if we're operating on a learner-centered approach where every learner is allowed to learn at their optimal rate, if they need more time, they're given it. If they need less time, they can advance more quickly. That means the learners are all over the place in terms of what it is they're learning. And that's where AI can really come in and be a powerful tool in tracking where every learner is, in serving the role as a tutor, an individual tutor. If a student has questions, it can guide them towards the correct answers rather than just giving it to them. So AI really gives us a power that we've really not been able to leverage to this point to really transform the very nature of the approach to education that we use. So I think in my mind, you know, AI has been around for decades, actually. It's really just been recently that we've seen it launch and become available in everyone's pockets. So it's suddenly ubiquitous. But we've had technologies for years that could be highly impactful to education, but haven't really fundamentally changed the way education has been done. So I think AI has the potential to have the most profound effect in changing education. The question really comes to be whether or not we're going to really leverage its capabilities to make sure that education can be changed. And the way that it would be changed is to personalize education in a fundamental way as opposed to with window dressing. So AI gives us the power to really fundamentally alter the way we approach education. So it's really working on a one-on-one, more of a one-on-one sort of approach. So the question remains whether we really take that leap or whether we're just trying to use it to slightly modify the way that we currently do things and the way that ultimately we've done things really for over 100 years. I think there are several aspects with AI that are important to consider. One is that, you know, it's something that we've talked about a lot. You know, it creeps into our sci-fi horror movies and that sort of thing, but AI can be used in negative ways, and it is being used in negative ways, whether that's a student cheating, whether it's a teacher grading an assignment without actually ever looking at it and seeing what the results are. We need to leverage AI in the right way, in an ethical way. That means that we're aware of potential biases that can be entering the data, which are certainly something that should be considered, and understanding, again, that it's a starting point, not an ending point for what we do. If we continue to teach the same sorts of things, which are kind of standardized knowledge, declarative knowledge, where we are expecting the students to be able to repeat dates and places without any real context or meaning or critical thinking, that's where AI becomes problematic because it can do things in an automated way very quickly and efficiently. We need to be using AI in a different way where we're adjusting the focus of our educational systems to be creating students who are lifelong learners, they're problem solvers, they're creative thinkers. In the past, our focus has very much been on coding and on replicating, doing the same sorts of math calculations over and over again, and kind of subsuming our soft skills, our creative thinking, our problem solving, the things that are harder to grade. That's really going to be problematic because AI can do those things very efficiently, very effectively, and if we continue to teach these same sorts of things to students, they can be using AI in the wrong way. So we need to be shifting the sort of goals of our educational system to be focusing on people who have more human-centered skills, who are creative, who can collaborate, who can problem solve, who can learn how to leverage AI in the correct way to solve complex problems ethically.